have a secret, and I've been wanting to tell you for so long, and it's been eating away at me every single day, but I was too scared to say it. But today is the day, and I'm just gonna go for it. Family, I have a sister
that I never told you about.
And I was scared that if I told you about her, you would like her better than me, because everyone always says that she's the prettier one, she's the funnier one, and I'm just the stinkier one. Smash like on this video right now if you want to meet my sister, and comment down below if you have a sister or brother yourself, because I'm curious,
and I'll be creeping and hearting some comments.
Okay, fine, family. You got me.
I'll let you meet her.
But promise me when you meet her
that you won't forget about me.
And that we'll still be family, right? All right, family, here's my sister.
She's a little younger than me, so she's kind of small.
3, 2, 1. Wow! Here she is.
Oh, wait, what? You ain't a girl? And you've actually been a boy this whole time? But I thought Peaches is a girl name. Oh.
Whoopsies.
Well, that's awkward.
But hey, family. Today, we're going to be watching a true story animation about an adopted sister who heard something she wasn't supposed to hear.
And it wasn't good.
My adopted sister, Mia, and I have been best friends since we were 5. Same as our mothers. When Mia's mother got sick last year and then passed away a few months later, my parents stepped in and became her foster parents and immediately began working on her adoption papers.
Sir, are your arms okay? This is a child you're taking care of, not a speedrun in Minecraft.
While it was sad that Mia lost her mom, I was happy that we could spend time together. I always wanted a sister, and now I had one.
Did she just say she's happy she lost her mom? So now she has more time to hang out with her? Kinda dark, but okay.
When we arrived home, Mia opened the kitchen door and stepped inside first, with me following closely on her heels. By the kitchen sink, Mom stood frantically trying to get red substance off her hands. Mom's eyes widened as she saw us, the water from the tap splashing on her hands.
Where's Dad?
Mia asked shakily. Mom looked at me. I grabbed Mia's hand. Dad's probably working at the office. Today's Wednesday. He always goes into the office on a Wednesday. I looked back and called out to Mom. Thanks for dyeing that dress that I needed.
Nina!
That's suspicious!
Ma'am, I know that wasn't ketchup on your hands.
And I know you weren't just making spaghetti either.
Family, I'm getting suspicious about this!
I saw you and Sean chatting before math class.
She's switching the subject.
Anything I should know about?
Well,
Mia's eyes lit up.
He asked me to go to the movies this Saturday.
That's awesome! As Mia spoke, I zoned out. I nodded my head and smiled ever so often, but my mind drifted towards Mom. I knew she needed me, but we couldn't let Mia know the truth. It would ruin everything.
I knew it! They're hiding something, family, and it's not good.
During dinner, Mom was smiling and laughing as usual.
Dad's been working late a lot over the past few weeks,
Mia said.
Well, you know he's up for a promotion, and he wants the best for you girls.
After dinner, Mia looked at me while we were washing the dishes.
Sapphire, do you think Dad is having an affair and Mom is trying to protect us?
I held Mia's hand. Mia, Dad loves Mom. He'll never cheat on her.
Mia, Dad loves Mom and he'll never cheat on her.
But you, on the other hand? Oh, he'll lie to you.
In fact, we're doing that right now.
You just don't know it yet.
I'm sorry. It's just that this is exactly how it started with my mom and dad, and I didn't want to believe it either. Oh.
Just because your dad was a loser doesn't mean my dad is one.
Whoa, that's harsh.
About an hour later, Mia came into the bedroom.
That is rude.
I pretended that I was asleep so I wouldn't have to tell her goodnight.
Sapphire! Sapphire!
Mia shook me. It was 1:15 in the morning. What is your problem, Mia? I was annoyed. What was so important that she needed to wake me up at this hour?
I just saw Dad leave in a white car.
I froze. She continued.
Do you think Mom knows?
Before I could stop her, Mia bolted out of the room. I hopped out of bed and ran behind her.
Dad leaving at 1 a.m. in a white car?
Unless he's leaving in a white limo or chasing after an ice cream truck.
I don't approve.
She pushed open our parents' door. Mom was standing by the window.
Dad's cheating on you. I just saw him get into a white car.
Mia shouted.
Uh-oh.
What are you talking about, Mia? Dad hasn't gotten home from the office yet. He called and said he'll be late. Mom, I know what I saw.
Mia stormed off. I'm sorry, Mom.
It's okay, Sapphire. Go back to bed.
I hugged Mom quickly and went back to bed.
What are they hiding from Mia?
I must know!
The next day, Mia avoided Dad at breakfast table, and then again at dinner, stating that she wasn't hungry.
Mm.
After dinner, I carried a plate of food for Mia and left it next to her books where she was studying by her desk. After a few minutes, Dad walked into the room.
Sapphire, can you leave so Mia and I can talk, please?
Sure. Whoa.
It's okay. I'd like her to stay. Whatever you have to say, you can say it in front of Sapphire.
Okay.
Dad sat on Mia's bed.
Mom told me that you think I'm having an affair.
Yes, Dad, I did tell Mom that. I saw you leaving that white truck, and you didn't even come home with some ice cream. What other evidence do we need? Either hand over my chocolate drumstick, or this case is closed. Guilty.
I just wanted to set the record straight and tell you that I love Mom very much, and I would never place myself in a position to lose her or you girls.
Do we believe it, family? Comment down below. Cheater or not cheater?
I saw you leave last night in a white car. Mom tried to make me feel as though I was crazy, but I know what I saw.
Mia pouted.
Mia, you were correct. I did leave home last night.
But Dad, I chimed in. Dad held up a finger and didn't say another word. Dad left the room and returned with a large box and placed it at Mia's feet.
Open it.
Mia knelt in front of the box and opened it.
Oh, it's a puppy!
Mia shrieked with excitement as she took the golden retriever out of the box.
Mom and I got it for you for your birthday.
Thank you, but my birthday is 3 weeks away.
We know, but Fred, one of the guys I work with, had to go on a business trip, so he had to get rid of the puppies before he left.
Dad, I'm so sorry.
Mia lowered her eyes.
Will you ever forgive me?
Of course not, Mia! I'm already signing the unadoption papers as we speak.
Of course I forgive you.
Mia and Dad hugged, and then Mia turned to me and hugged me too. Dad and I exchanged looks, and I sighed with relief. Mia and I stayed up to play with the puppy, who she called Monty.
Mm.
Dad took Monty when they left and closed the door behind them.
So cute!
So, Mom, what are we going to do? I asked as I looked at my parents, a worried frown on my face.
I asked as I looked up at my parents with a confused and puzzled face.
Why you gotta move your arms like that, girl? You ain't a zombie from The Walking Dead.
Well, Sapphire.
Mom held Dad's hand and looked at him.
Our backs are against the wall.
But Mom, there must be another way. Mia loves it here. Just then, we heard a small gasp. We looked to the doorway, and there stood Mia. I wondered if she had heard what I said, and when she ran off with a hurt expression on her face, I knew that she had. Mia! I ran behind her into our bedroom. I found Mia face down in her bed, sobbing. Mia, I gently placed my hand on her shoulder. Please, let me explain.
Why don't you guys want me anymore?
Tears streaked her face. Mia, of course we want you.
Then why do you guys want to get rid of me?
She wiped her eyes. We don't want to get rid of you. Dad got the promotion, but it means that we have to move. I don't want to move, and I was telling Mom and Dad that you loved it here and you wouldn't want to move either.
Are you sure?
I hugged Mia. Of course I am. You can't get rid of us that easily.
I think they're still lying.
Mia pulled away and looked at me suspiciously.
But why are you guys having a family meeting without me?
Well, you weren't home. I shifted on the bed next to Mia.
But you could have waited till I came home.
Look, we're so sorry. Dad needed to make a quick decision or they're gonna give the promotion to someone else. But you're right. We should have waited for you since you're a part of this family. During dinner, Mom asked us if we'll be going to the prom, which was being held in a few weeks.
I haven't heard you girls talking about it. Girls are usually excited about the prom.
I'm not sure, but maybe Sean will ask Mia to the prom. I giggled as Mia's face turned red.
No need to feel embarrassed. Crushes are a part of growing up.
When Mia's ready, she'll tell us about her boyfriend.
2 weeks before prom, Mia and I went to the mall to purchase new dresses.
I really wish my mom was here to see this. Oh, Mia.
Mom gave her a quick hug.
If you keep her memory alive, she will always be with you.
Maybe Mia's real mom will always be with her, but you guys? I'm not so sure, because y'all are definitely still hiding something.
As we were headed towards the food court, someone called out Mia's name behind us.
Hi, Sean.
Mia blushed.
The boy.
I watched Mia and Sean from the entrance. They chatted for a few minutes before Sean walked off, and Mia turned in my direction with a huge grin on her face. So, did he ask you to the prom? I asked as she approached.
Yes!
Mia squealed excitedly. Mia quickly found Mom in the store and gave her the good news. Finally, the big night arrived. Mia was in the bathroom as I tried to zip my dress up. I ran to get Mom's help. Mom, can you help?
Linda, I'm not speaking about it anymore. My decision is final.
Dad stormed out of the kitchen. Mom inhaled deeply. Mom, is everything okay? Mom smiled.
Everything is fine, dear. Let's get you and Mia dressed for the prom.
Everything is fine, dear. Your dad just yelled at me and got his stinky anchovy breath all over my face. And now I'm probably gonna have a breakout of pimples in the morning. Couldn't be happier.
At 6:30, Sean arrived and Mia and I were ready.
Ooh.
Monty danced around our legs as Dad turned to take pictures of us. While taking the pictures, Dad staggered backwards. Dad, are you okay? I went to him.
Oh, I'm fine. I'm probably just as excited as you two. I'll be okay.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll tell you that, you're taking the pictures all wrong. You're getting this angle when you're supposed to get this angle. And now all the pictures are gonna come out on my bad side. Dang it, Dad, this is prom, not a football game. Let's take this seriously.
As I turned to face Mia, Dad collapsed on the ground. Mom! Mom! I screamed. Mom rushed into the living room and screamed,
Alan!
She turned to Mia and I.
Call an ambulance!
Within 5 minutes, an ambulance arrived and Dad was rushed to the hospital. Mom, Mia, Sean, and I hopped into the family car and followed close behind. A few hours later, Dr. Motley walked into the waiting room and asked to speak to Mom. Based on Mom's reaction during their discussion, I knew something was wrong.
Well, yeah. I could tell you the first thing wrong is that your doctor's an alien! The heck? That can't be safe!
Needless to say, prom night didn't turn out as we expected. Dad was released from hospital a few days later. While resting at home one Saturday afternoon, Mom returned with a letter. She asked us to gather in the living room for a family meeting.
Well, we finally got the letter from the Children's Authority. And Dad and I are officially Mia's parents.
We all cheered and hugged Mia. Mom sat on the armchair and held Dad's hand.
Now that Mia is officially family, we can tell her the truth.
Mia looked at us.
Truth about what?
Uh-oh. Well, Mia, we decided to wait until after we adopted you to tell you that we're actually high-profile criminals, and you're about to be our newest accomplice. You ever wear a ski mask before? If you haven't, don't worry. You'll learn quick.
Well, Mia, I have leukemia.
Dad spoke slowly. Mia placed her hand over her mouth as Dad continued.
We couldn't tell you anything about it, because when they questioned you at the Children's Authority, we didn't want you to lie. We couldn't take the risk of losing you.
Mom continued.
We had to portray being healthy parents, or they would have placed you with another family. Before your mom died, I promised her that I would take care of you. She was my best friend, and you and Sapphire, well, I couldn't break that friendship up either.
Mom wipes away the tears that rolled down her cheeks.
We asked a friend of ours who is a doctor to forge documents giving your father a clean bill of health. At the hospital, Dr. Motley said that your father only has a few more months to live.
Mia ran to Dad and threw her arms around him and cried.
I wished you would have told me earlier.
I walked up behind Mia. When Dad came home late or left home at wee hours of the morning, he was going to treatment. We couldn't risk him going during work hours, so he had to do it after. So that night, you did see Dad go, and it wasn't to get Monty either. Late one night, Mom got the call that Dad passed away peacefully in his sleep. I think of my dad every day and the sacrifices that he made for our family. I hope that one day, when I become a parent, the love that I have for my children will be as unconditional as my dad.
Now I kind of feel bad. Whole video I was calling him a snake, when in reality he actually had a snake inside of him. 'Cause he has cancer! And the only reason he was lying to Mia was to protect her. Maybe his body wasn't healthy, but at least we know his heart was working good. 'Cause that's the cutest thing I've ever heard. I guess the lesson for today is that your parents always want the best for you. Just kissed the microphone there. As I was saying, your parents always want the best for you, even if it doesn't seem like it at the time. And also, never trust your doctor if he's an alien! 'Cause who knows if her dad is even actually oofed right now? He might have just got abducted into outer space. But anyways, family, that is all of the true story animation that I have for you today. Smash like if you like this video and hit subscribe if you don't want your parents to turn into an alien. Also, don't forget to go follow me on my Instagram right down here. I love you all so much, and I'll see you all in the next video. Oh.